Everyone. Yes, students.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. Now,
yes,
expecting that because we have discussed whatever questions I have framed regarding the same topic, because just now we have discussion on the same topic, administrative setup. Okay. So of education. So this is the question number one. The UGC, however, was formally established in November as a statutory body of the Government of India through an Act of Parliament for the coordination, determination, and maintenance of the standards of university education in India. And the options are 1956, 1946, 1966, and 1976. Now tell me which one is the correct option.
1956.
Yes, very nice. Means you were attentive towards the lecture. Very nice. Okay. See, and in these questions also, they are telling that what are the duties or what you can say, what is the main function of this UGC. Okay. So during the coordination, determination, and maintenance of standard of University of Education in India. Okay. So again, they will reframe the question and they will ask about this. What is the main task of UGC? Okay. Yes. And then the second is the All India Council for Technical Education, AICTE, was set up in -- as an advisory body and later on in 1987, given the statutory status by an Act of Parliament. And the options are, the first is 1946, the second is 1955, the third is 1965, and fourth is 1945. Yes.
1945.
Oh, very nice. The correct option is 1945. Okay. And they see, they may ask the questions about this also. I think I have also asked the same question. What is the full form of AICTE? That is All India Council for Technical Education. Okay. This is not related to teacher education. You might be confused regarding this TE. Okay. Yes. National Council for Teacher Education, that is nothing but the NCTE, is an Indian government body set up under the National Council for Teacher Education Act 1993 in which year? Just tell me the year.
1995.
Yes. Yes. The correct answer is 1995. Very nice. It means you are attentive towards the lectures. It's really nice. Yes. Now, which body determine and maintain standards for higher education in India? Yes. The first is UGC, second is AICTE, third is NCTE, and the fourth one is all of the above. Yes, the correct answer is
all of the above.
Yes. Can you justify why you have selected this particular answer?
UGC is you told us UGC, AICT, and NCT is National Council of Teachers Education. That is also higher education.
Yes, because see, basically for the smooth administration, they are going to do administration in two divisions. The one is related to the school education and other is related to the higher education. And all these are the commissions and the councils. They are related to the higher education only. UGC means University Grant Commission, that is related to the university level education. Then AICTE means All India Council for Technical Education. It is not, again, I'm telling you, this is not teacher education. Okay. This is related to, again, this is related to higher education, and third one, that is National Council for Teacher Education. Okay. So all these three bodies, they are related to the higher education only. So the option number four, that is the correct option, all of the above. Good. Yes. Yes. The Ministry of Education, the short form is MOE, is a Ministry of Government of India responsible for the implementation of The first is the National Education Policy on Education, the National Education Policy on Education 2020. The third is the National Policy on Education 1992. And the fourth is the National Policy on Education 1986. Now tell me which is the correct answer. Please read the question carefully. It is very simple question.
First one, I think.
Okay.
Second one, National Education Policy on Education 2020.
Okay. Apart from these two answers, any other answer?
And this 2020 is HRD through minister is also involved. MP.
See. Again, you are confusing here. See, the question is the Ministry of Education is a ministry of government. Of course, it is a ministry of government of India, which is responsible for the implementation. Okay, so implementation of, and the correct option is the National Policy on Education, because timely they are going to implement the current education policy. Right now, yes, right now we are having in 2020, I think in the month of July, we have the new education policy, that is National Policy on Education, a National Education Policy. The both are same. See, National Policy on Education and National Education Policy, both are same. And see, these are the different years when whatever suggestions are given by. So National Education Policy 86, 92. These are the different particular national education policies. But this is the general thing, that is the National Policy on Education. So the correct answer is National Policy on Education. Understood about this? फिर आपने आप confused क्यों हुए आप मैं आपको बताती हूँ क्योंकि जैसे मैंने पहले आपको बोला था कि when this NPE discussion was there under the governance of Narendra Modi, okay, so at that time the name of the HRD ministry, it again changes to its original name, that is Ministry of Education. So maybe because of that you have confusion regarding the selection of the options, right? Yes,
ma'am. I first chose this only, and yes. I was so, but I'm just thinking someone has told that 2020, but I was thinking it was involvement.
Yes, it should be general.
Yeah,
okay. After some years also there will be other. Yes. See, this is the year means when that particular education policy is declared. This is the year of declaration. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Yes. The next is. See, the Department of School Education and Literacy, which deals with primary, secondary and higher secondary education, adult education, literacy, and the fourth is all of the above.
All of the above, ma'am.
Yes, very nice answer. The answer is all of the above, because basically there are two departments. The first is related to the Department of Higher Education and second is the Department of School Education. Okay, so just recall the first department. Okay, I think one more question is there regarding that, so we'll discuss with that. So here the option number four, that is the correct option. Yes, India had the Ministry of Education since. The first option is 1950, the second is 1947, the third is 1957, and fourth one is 1953.
1947.
Yes, very nice, because after when we have independence at that, from that time, from that period, we have Ministry of Education. Okay, and I think those who were absent initially, it is for them only. So initial name was the Ministry of Education, and in 1985 when Rajiv Gandhi, he was the prime minister at that time, means under the Rajiv Gandhi government, you can say the governance, there is a renaming of this ministry, and the rename was Ministry of HRD, that is Human Resource Development. Okay, but in this National Policy on Education 2022, again under the Narendra Modi's government, the new name again rechanged, and we can say the change to the previous one, and now it is we are knowing the same ministry by the Ministry of Education. Yes. The question is in, let me log this answer, and the correct is 1947. Yes, in 1985, dash dash change name of Ministry of Education to Ministry of Human Resource Development. Just that, now I, yes,
oh,
yes, yes. Because Indira Gandhi, she expired in 1983, and after that Rajiv Gandhi, he was the Prime Minister, and under his governance, he changed the name of the Ministry of Education to Ministry of Human Resource Development. So you should remember the year also, 1985, and the government also. So that the, at that time there was a government of Rajiv Gandhi. So this is the correct option. Very nice. Yes. In, again, I shuffle the same question. In dash dash, Rajiv Gandhi government changed name of Ministry of Education to Ministry of Human Resource Development. And the year is, yes, it is very simple. Yes, 1985. Very nice. Yes. With the public announcement of newly drafted National Education Policy by the Narendra Modi government, Ministry of HRD was renamed back to the Ministry of Education. And the answer, yes, a very simple answer, because just now I explained the entire things. Okay, so and the correct answer is 2020. This is the recent National Education Policy. Yes. Now this is very challenging for, if you are attentive towards the lecture, then you can easily give the answers. The Department of Higher Education, which deals with university level education, the first option. The second is technical education. The third is scholarship, and the fourth one is all of the above.
All of the above.
Yes. All of the above. Because there were two divisions. The first is related to, yes. What was the name of the first department?
Department of Higher Education.
This is the Department of Higher Education. Now tell me the name of the second department.
Department of School Education and Literacy.
Very nice, Sonali. The Department of School Education and Literacy. And this is the Department of Higher Education. It is dealing with university level education, technical education, and scholarship as well. So we are going to lock option number four, that is all of the above. Okay. Now, find out odd man out. The first is NCERT, second is CBSC, the third is UGC, and fourth one is KVS.
UGC.
UGC.
Yes, please look at each option very carefully, and then you can select your option.
KVS. I will go KVS.
Okay, why you have selected KVS?
Because ma'am, NCERT, CBSC, UGC, these are the board, means what we can say, they provide the guidelines or set the curriculum, syllabus, but KVS is different.
See, actually, first time you may think that the option number four is the correct option, which is the real odd man out, but actually the correct one is, I'm going to highlight the correct one, that is UGC. Okay. Yes, because already we have saw different councils and different boards which are related to the education, as basically with the primary and secondary education. So the NCERT, it is related to that. The CBSC, it is also related to even the KVS. So these three, option number 1, 2, and 3, they are related to the primary and secondary education. Okay, and here the UGC, it is the only one option which is related to the higher education. So these are the different bodies which are related to the primary and secondary education, and UGC, it is a body which is related to higher education only. So from that point of view, here the option number 3, that is the odd man out. Okay. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. The main objective of HRD ministry, the main objectives of HRD ministry are The first is formulating the national policy on education and to ensure that it is implemented in letter and spirit. The second is plan development, including expanding access and improving quality of the educational institution throughout the country, including in regions where people do not have easy access to education. Third is paying special attention to disadvantaged group. Just give me 1 minute break. Yes, student?
Okay,
sure, sure.
Just give me 1 minute break.
नहीं ऐसे नहीं
हेलो यस सी ऑप्शंस आर इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू दीज आर सी डिफरेंट स्टेटमेंट्स आर गिवन दीज आर नॉट द ऑप्शंस ओके सो दीज आर द डिफरेंट स्टेटमेंट्स और यू कैन सी द डिफरेंट ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ एचआरडी मिनिस्ट्री And the options are here. Have you read all the options? Yes. The third is paying special attention to disadvantage. I think we should start from the beginning. Yes. The main objective of HRD ministry are, first is formulating the national policy on education and to ensure that it is implemented in letter and spirit. Second is plan development, including expanding access and improving quality of the educational institution throughout the country, including in regions where people do not have easy access to education. Paying special attention to disadvantaged groups like the poor, females and minorities. Provide financial help in the form of scholarship, loan, subsidy, etc. to deserving students from the deprived sections of the society. Okay, and here the options are option number 1 and 2, 2 and 3, 1 and 3 and all. Now tell me which is the correct option.
Option 1, ma'am. 1 and 2.
Okay, option 1 and 2. Yes. Apart from this, option number 1, any other answer? Yes. Actually, all these are the main objective of HRD, and all objectives are we have to go with the all objectives, and we are going to select the option number 4 as the correct option here. Because, see, formulating national policy on education and to ensure means not only the formulation, but they have to ensure also whether they are going to implement whether the policy it is going to implement properly or not. Then plan the development, including expanding access and improving quality of the educational institutions throughout the country. So this is also one main aim of the what we can say HRD ministry. See, here we are talking about the objectives of HRD ministry. So main ministry hai uske bare mein hum baat kar rahe hain. Fir what we can say, the another name for HRD ministry is Ministry of Education. Okay, so the objectives are same. So अभी देखो सबके लिए एजुकेशन क्या है उसका सार्वत्रिकरण है और जो भी 14 साल के बच्चों तक सबको एजुकेशन देना ही देना है एंड अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस देयर आल्सो इट्स नॉट रिलेटेड टू द हायर एजुकेशन बट देयर आल्सो फोकसिंग ऑन द एडल्ट एजुकेशन आल्सो देयर इज वन सेक्शन रिगार्डिंग द एडल्ट एजुकेशन आल्सो एंड द लिटरेसी आल्सो ओके they are also giving special attention to the disadvantaged group like the poor yahan pe kya hota hai unko kya wo kya karte dekho niche bhi diya hai scholarships dete hai loan dete hai subsidy dete hai unko theek hai aur yahan pe special attention to disadvantaged aap dekhoge wahan pe jo bhi poor bacche unko uniform diya jata hai theek hai abhi to 8th tak sabhi ko jo bhi government school hai 8th tak sabhi ko books jo bhi hai wo unko free mein diye jate hai theek hai तो ऐसी कुछ फैसिलिटीज है जो यहाँ पे ये देना, मतलब उनका मेन ये है कि सबको शिक्षा देना, ऐसे कोई भी है जो उससे वंचित ना रह पाए, सबको शिक्षा मिले और सब आगे चले जाए, ठीक है। इसलिए ऑल दीज आर द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ HRD मिनिस्ट्री। यस, द नेक्स्ट इज आई थिंक वी मिस दिस। HRD इनोवेशन सेल वॉज एस्टेब्लिश इन अगस्त डैश डैश बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ ह्यूमन रिसोर्स डेवलपमेंट एट ऑल इंडिया काउंसिल फॉर टेक्निकल एजुकेशन। ओके, सो नाउ टेल मी, आई थिंक वी डू, यू डोंट नो द करेक्ट आंसर ऑफ दिस। एक्चुअली इट एस्टैब्लिश इन 2018, 2018 में इसको एस्टैब्लिश किया गया था। सी, इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज, सी नाउ द नेम हैज चेंज, MHRD, दैट इज मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ HRD, एंड नाउ इट इज मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एजुकेशन। सो दिस इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज मिनिस्ट्री, MOE, इनोवेशन सेल, एंड इट इज एस्टैब्लिश इन ऑगस्ट 2018। ओके, दिस इज द राइट आंसर। एंड अंडर वॉट, सी, बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ ह्यूमन रिसोर्स डेवलपमेंट एट ऑल इंडिया काउंसिल फॉर टेक्निकल एजुकेशन। दिस इज द अनादर मेन काउंसिल ऑफ काउंसिल विच इज रिलेटेड टू हायर एजुकेशन। सी, दिस इज रिलेटेड टू, नॉट दिस इज रिलेटेड टू द स्कूल एजुकेशन एंड लिटरेसी, दिस इज रिलेटेड टू द हायर एजुकेशन डिपार्टमेंट। ओके, सो आई एम गोइंग टू लॉक द ऑप्शन नंबर टू, दैट इज 2018। यस, सी दिस, दिस इज द, व्हाट यू कैन से, लेट मी रीड द स्टेटमेंट फर्स्ट। MOEs, that is Ministry of Education Innovation Cell, and the initial, that is, these both are the correct. Okay, MHRD's Innovation Cell, but now this one is the correct because now the name has again changed and now it is Ministry of Education. So Ministry of Education's Innovation Cell was established in August 2018 by Ministry of Human Resource Development at All India Council for technical education too. And see, these are the different things. Systematically, what is the main purpose of development of this particular cell? Systematically foster the culture of innovation in all major higher education institutions in India. Systematically foster the culture of entrepreneurship. Systematically foster the culture of startups in all major higher education institutions in India. And the last option is all of the above. I think we have not discussed about this, so I'm going to tell you the option, correct option. Here the option all number four, yes, that is all of the above, it is the correct option. And simply we can say that the main purpose of this MOE innovation cell is systematically foster the culture, okay, the culture of innovation, the culture of entrepreneurship and the culture of startup in all major higher education institutions in India. So we are going with option number four. Yes.
Ma'am, it is particularly for higher education only. Then every.
See, why it is higher education? Because All India Council for Technical Education. This council is related to, we have studied about the main three councils, that is UGC, AICTE and NCTE. So these three commissions and councils, or we can see the three main bodies, they are related to higher education only. And if you can see here, all major higher education, yes,
higher education,
yes, higher education institutions in India. ठीक है? तो यहाँ पे भी आपको थोड़ा सा शफल करके क्वेश्चन पूछ सकते हैं। मींस बेसिकली इस पर्टिकुलर इनोवेशन सेल इज वर्किंग फॉर विच टाइप ऑफ एजुकेशन। ओके, सो हायर एजुकेशन, प्राइमरी एजुकेशन, सेकेंडरी एजुकेशन, एडल्ट एजुकेशन, लाइक दिस। सो दे विल आस्क वन मोर क्वेश्चन ऑन दिस, जस्ट शफलिंग द स्टेटमेंट। यस, द हाइएस्ट अथॉरिटी ऑफ एजुकेशन एट स्टेट लेवल इज, it is very simple. Now I'm expecting quick responses from your side. The highest authority of education at state level is
Minister of Education.
Just recall the hierarchy, we'll get the answer. Minister of Education. At the state level, the Minister of Education appointed by, who is going to appoint the Minister of Education at the state level? The option number one is Chief Minister of a state, then the Prime Minister, Education Minister, Minister of Central level, and none of the above.
None of the above.
Okay, so what do you discuss? Who is going to appoint the Minister of Education? Okay, let me switch on the Word document. Yes, Minister of Education appointed by the Chief Minister of a state. Okay, so here, which is the correct option? Yes,
CM of the
state. Yes, CM of the state. This is the correct option. At the state level, dash dash is generally senior IAS officer. Just recall the hierarchy and whatever I explained during the lecture. Yes? Director of Education? Yes, any other answer? Yes. The first option is Education Minister, second is Education Secretary, third is Director of Education, fourth is Circle Education Officer.
Director of Education.
See, whenever we discuss on this topic, I told you that the Education Minister, maybe that Education Minister is not in touch with the secondary education or higher secondary education or the primary education. मतलब यहाँ पे education ministry जरूरी नहीं कि उनको वो particular education system के बारे में उनको पता हो, ठीक है? तो यहाँ पे उनको assist करने के लिए there is a mediator and that mediator or what can say there is a linker, someone is there who is going to link the education minister and the director of education. Just recall the hierarchy, because here the option number two, it is the correct option, that is Education Secretary, because after Education Ministry, there is a secretariat, then there is a directorate, and then there is a Circle Education Officer. This is the hierarchy. So here, the basically, the whatever policies, again, the policies, these are the policy makers, we can say, and actually execution is done at the director of education, or we can say the director of education level. Okay, I'm again switching on the Word document. You'll get the answers. It will be in front of you. Yes, you can see the secretary of education. Here it is given that senior IAS officer. Okay, education secretary generally senior IAS officer. So option number two, it is correct. Yes. Is it? Don't get any confusion. Should I move ahead? Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. What is full form of AICTE? All India Child Trainer of Education, All India Council for Technical Education, All India Council for Teacher Education, and the fourth one is none of the above.
Option number two.
Yes, very nice. Option number two, All India Council for Technical Education. Yes. What are the main purposes of forming NCTE? NCTE means what? What is full form of NCTE? National Council for Teaching and Teacher Education. Okay. It is for or of, just check it once and tell me. National Council of Teacher Education or National Council for Teacher Education?
For.
Sure? First check it and tell me. Okay, let me tell the options. The option number one is to plan and to coordinate development of teacher education system throughout the country. Option number two is to regulate and maintain the norms and standards in the teacher education system. Option number three is involved in the decision making for the school activities. And option number four is all of these. Okay. Yes, any other one's answer?
My first one.
Okay.
Maybe all of these.
Please options carefully, because of course it is related to planning and coordination regarding the teacher education system. It also maintain norms and standards in the teacher education system. Okay. So it is clear that the both options are correct. Okay. Again, see, there is a connection between the teacher education and the school education. Okay, because the teacher educations, they are the teacher education institutions, they are going to, what you can say, going to mold the teachers, and in the future they are going to enter in the teaching professions, and it is directly or indirectly it is related with the school education. Okay, so here this NCT, they are also involving in the decision making regarding the school activities. That is also a purpose of, main purpose of NCT. And the, so option number four, it is correct. Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Point I've got confused. The third one, involved in the decision making for school activities, means ma'am,
for example, suppose, okay, aap abhi teacher, aap teacher, aap student teacher, so theek hai, agar aapko abhi जो टीचर एजुकेशन जो भी इंस्टीट्यूशन है वो सभी किसके अंडर आते हैं, एनसीटी के अंडर आते हैं, ठीक है। तो यहाँ पे क्या होता है, यहाँ पे सब इसमें कनेक्शन है, वहाँ पे कोई भी सभी बॉडीज जो भी है या फिर काउंसिल्स है, कुछ कमीशन है, सब इंटरलिंक्ड है, वहाँ पे कोई सेपरेट नहीं है, ठीक है। अब बेसिकली जब भी टीचर एजुकेशन का सवाल आता है तो ऑटोमेटिकली वहाँ स्कूल एजुकेशन तो आ ही जाता है। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, स्कूल एक्टिविटी विल टेक एग्जाम्पल ऑफ कंटिन्यूस कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव for continuous comprehensive evaluation. Okay, so for example, if the they are expecting that there should be at the school level, there should be continuous comprehensive evaluation. Okay, so how it should be, which way it is possible to really take the continuous comprehensive evaluation of the student, which tools the particular school can be follow for this proper implementation of the CCE. Okay, so such type of decisions can be taken by not the entire decision, but it involves in the decision making. So this is one activity. I just like give you one. Yes.
Example of school activity which you have given, right?
Yes.
School activity.
School activity means don't consider that the particular school is conducting different so many activities. Okay, school activity means generalize that CCE it is one activity, that is continuous comprehensive evaluation of the student. Okay, अगर आपको ये आपके syllabus में भी नहीं रखा कि continuous comprehensive evaluation कैसे करना है, कौन से tools हम उसके लिए use कर सकते हैं, तो अगर आप बाद में as a आप teaching profession में जाओगे तो आप वहाँ पे कर पाओगे, वहाँ पे कुछ गैप रह जाएगा अगर उसमें कनेक्शन नहीं है तो. सो दैट्स व्हाई दिस एनसीटी, दे आर आल्सो इन्वॉल्व्ड इन द डिसीजन मेकिंग फॉर द सर्टेन स्कूल एक्टिविटीज. ओके, नॉट ऑल द स्कूल एक्टिविटीज बट द सर्टेन स्कूल एक्टिविटीज. ओके, सो द ऑप्शन नंबर फोर, दैट इज करेक्ट. इट इज क्लियर? शुड आई मूव अहेड? यस
यस यस मैम.
व्हाट इज द मेन फंक्शन ऑफ साइंस सुपरवाइजर इन सेकेंडरी एजुकेशन? The option number one, to observe the science labs of all, to evaluate the labs, to collect the funds for lab, and the last is none of these.
Ma'am, to observe the science lab for all.
Yes, very nice. The option number one is correct. And actually, the science supervisor post, where it is, at which level it is?
Yes.
Yes, it is at the district level. Yes, it is at the district level, and the main task of the science supervisor is, and it is related to secondary education only, to observe the science labs. Okay, and again he is supposed to send the report to the district education officer. Okay, of course the district education officer for the secondary education only, because at the district level there are again the officer for the elementary and for the secondary education. Okay, yes. Through which department our country is operating its educational administration system? Department of School Education and Literacy, Department of Higher Education, both of these and none of the above? Very simple question. Through which departments our country is operating its educational administration system? Yes, very nice. See, here it is not given that about the HRD ministry, about the Ministry of Education, how the Ministry of Education, they are operating this education system in India. See, they have just given it in other way. They are asking the other way. Through which department our country is operating its educational administration system? So यहाँ पे central level का ही आता है. Central level यानी HRD ministry, यानी Ministry of Education. So here they are asking about the Ministry of Education and the departments of Ministry of Education for the educational administration. So here the option number 3, it is correct, both of these. Very nice. Yes, UGC is a national level body which is concerned with option number 1, higher education, option number 2, school education, option number 3, vocational education, option number 4, all of the above. Yes, now tell me which is the correct. Yes,
higher education, ma'am.
Yes, why you have selected this higher education? Yes, see, in the previous question only there was two departments, means HRD ministry, they are working in the two department, with the two department. There are two departments under the HRD ministry. The first is Department of School Education and Literacy, and second is Department of Higher Education. We have already saw the three main bodies under which are working under the higher education, working for the higher education, and the bodies are UGC. The second is All India Council for Technical Education, and third is NCTE. So UGC, of course, it is a national level body, and which is concerned with, is it related to school education? Yes or no? It is related to vocational education? Of course, no. So it is only related to the higher education. So we are going to select the option number 1. Is it okay? Understood about this? आप सबसे पहले आप HRD ministry, उसके अंदर दो डिपार्टमेंट है, वो डिपार्टमेंट के अंदर उनके टास्क क्या क्या है, ठीक है, वो किस चीज से डील करते हैं. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, सपोज वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द स्कूल एजुकेशन लिटरेसी, सो हियर दे आर डीलिंग विथ द प्राइमरी सेकेंडरी, देन यस प्राइमरी सेकेंडरी, देन नेक्स्ट इज
एलिमेंट्री.
प्राइमरी एलिमेंट्री बोथ आर सेम. Primary, secondary, higher secondary, even adult education and literacy. Okay, so you have to remember this. And in case of
department,
yes,
ma'am, these all which you have named comes under Department of School Education and
Literacy. Yes. Primary, secondary, higher secondary, even higher adult education and literacy. All this comes under this particular department. There are main two departments. This is the first one, and the second is Department of Higher Education. And in Department of Higher Education, of course, the main two things are there: the university level education, and the second is the technical education. Okay, so please remember these things. Yes, so UGC, it is a national level body and which is concerned with the higher education. Yes, the next question is, under which act NCT Act of Teacher Education was passed? And for this you just need to what you can see in the by heart the years only, nothing else.
Option 1,
1993.
Yes.
NCT Act 1993.
Yes, very nice. NCT Act 1993. Very nice answer. Which is the highest authority of education at state level? Which is the highest authority of education at state level? This is very simple question.
Minister of Education.
Yes, you are very correct. The answer is Minister of Education. He is the highest authority of education at the state level. Yes. See, Circle Education Officer is concerned with the establishment and coordination at which level? Whole state. Second is region, circle, division. Third is district and fourth is block. Yes. Just recall the hierarchy.
Four.
No. Any other answer? See, it is given here, dear. See, Circle Education Officer, because after Director of Education, and in between the Director of Education and the District Education Officer, there is one authority, that is Circle Education Officer. Okay, so there are different regions, circles or division, and this particular officer is concerned with the establishment and coordination at which level? At region, circle or division level. See, because see here again we have to apply the odd man out, or you can say the elimination factor. See, of course, the Circle Education Officer, it is not related to entire state. The block, so there are other names for block, the tehsils. Okay, so again it is comes under the lower authorized level. It is not related to the district, because for district there is a District Education Officer. So like this only you can get answer, correct answer. Okay, so the option number two is, it is a correct, that is region, circle or division. Okay, have you understood about this? Okay, I'm switching on the page. You can see here. See, Director of Education, yes, and after that there is a Circle Education Officer into region, circle and divisions, because the state, it is divided into the region, circles and divisions. मैं आपको एक बात बताती हूँ. हमने जब एच एस सी बोर्ड हमने देखा था, तो वहां पे टोटल डिविजन्स कितने हैं? दे आर हैविंग 9 डिविजन्स. ओके, सो महाराष्ट्र स्टेट में डिस्ट्रिक्ट अलग है, लेकिन डिविजन्स लिमिटेड रहते हैं. और वो डिविजन्स किसके ऊपर आता है? अफकोर्स डिस्ट्रिक्ट के ऊपर, क्योंकि हर एक डिविजन दो या तीन डिस्ट्रिक्ट का जो भी है उसके अकॉर्डिंगली रहता है. ठीक है, सो सर्कल एजुकेशन ऑफिसर. And he is the district education officer. So he, you can say that he, the circle education officer, is it is a mediator, or you can say that it links the director of education and district education officer. ये भी questions वहाँ पे पूछ सकते हैं. अगर आपके basic concept clear है, then easily you can write the answer. Not write the answer, you can find the correct option. You can say yes. Highest level officer of education at district level is, very simple answer. Highest level officer of education at district level is, yes, correct option is
Director of DEO.
Yes, of course, district level, that is district education officer.
Yes, ma'am.
See the full form. CEO, Circle Education Officer. It is not for the district, it is just one level above to the district. So we are going to eliminate CEO. Yes. What about DPI? DPI means Director of Public Instruction, which is also called as Director of Education. Okay. So here the full form, it comes under the Secretariat, or you can say the Education Secretary. Okay. So, but here we are talking about the district level. So again, we are going to eliminate the second one. And the first option is DEO, that is District Education Officer. So we are going to select this correct option as the correct option. Okay, clear about this? Yes. I think this was the last MCQ, and do you want to know that how many MCQs you have practiced related to only one topic? You can see here. So I think two MCQs on one page, and total how many pages? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 pages. I think 14 into 2 minus 1. 27 MCQs only on one topic we have practiced today. Yes, the topic is clear to you? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, any doubt? See, let's see the let's just recall the hierarchy. So suppose there is an education ministry. Okay, then there is a secretary, or you can say the education secretary. Then there is, yes, after education secretary, there will be
district
director of education. After director of education, there will be circle education officer. After circle education officer, there will be district education officer. Again, it is different for the primary and the secondary education. Okay. And again, they are assisted by the deputy and the assistant education officer. Yes. Then there will be block education officer, and this block education officer, it is only related to the elementary education or the primary education, we can say. So it is also called as block elementary education officer. After block education officer, there will be, yes, there will be central head teacher, which is that is nothing but the Kendra Pramukh. Okay, so this is the hierarchy related to the administrative setup of education in Maharashtra or in every state of India. Okay, you're supposed to remember this hierarchy, and whatever shortcuts are there, you're supposed to remember all the shortcuts.